Okay, let's move on to the next trade now. Selling continued to mount on the Treasury market today, lifting yields across the board, pushing the spread to a new record for a second straight session. While some say higher rates signal economic improvement, our next guest says it should be raising a red flag. Peter Schiff, president of Euro Pacific Capital and author of Crash Proof 2.0, joins us from Stamford. Peter, it is always a pleasure to speak with you.
Thanks for having me on again.
Historically, rising rates equals a recovering economy. Why is it different this time around?
Well, also, rising rates could be a sign of inflation. I think that's what you have here. Remember, the only reason that it looks like the economy is growing is because the Federal Reserve is creating a lot of inflation to artificially prop up the GDP. And I think it's that inflation and inflation expectations that explains the backup in interest rates and not any positive outlook for the economy.
So, Peter, it's Karen. If the GDP seeming growth is really a mirage, then and inflation isn't really there, could it be a widening of credit spreads that's actually in the long end?
Well, inflation isn't the mirage. That's actually here.
And but so if the GDP doesn't perform, if GDP growth isn't really there.
Yeah, you can still have inflation with a weak economy. In fact, the weaker economy, the worse the inflation is going to get, because the Fed fights off the economic weakness by creating inflation. And so in the worst inflations that have broken out historically, they happen in very weak economies with high levels of unemployment.
So you're looking for stagflation?
Yes, but with a lot of inflation and a lot of stagnation.
Okay.
Peter, any chance you see hyperinflation?
Yeah, unfortunately, that is the worst case scenario. I don't know how to, handicap it, but I do know this. If we don't come to our senses soon, if we continue to push the envelope on the stimulus and pursue this policy, hyperinflation is not only possible, it's inevitable.
Pete, take your investor cap off and put your trader cap on real quick. You've seen gold pull back to basically the levels that India bought their stake. Is this now attractive? As a trader, I know it's attractive all the time to you, but is it more attractive now, given the move we've seen lower?
Yeah, I mean, look, we've had a nice pullback. We've dropped over $100 from the highs. I think there's a lot of support, around the $1,000 level or just below. So to the extent it ever gets back below there again, I would buy all the gold I can get my hands on. But it doesn't mean you have to wait for that. It's a big enough pullback. If you look at the action in the gold stocks, the gold stocks corrected about 20%, while the metal only corrected about 10. But the gold stocks have traded pretty strong the last couple of days. That's usually the sign of a short-term bottom when you didn't see more weakness in gold stocks, even though like gold was down today, but gold stocks were stronger. I think there's a good sign that we've got a short-term bottom. And if you're a trader, you probably want to trade it from the long side.
Peter, I apologize. I got to ask you about hyperinflation again because I didn't hear your answer. You truly believe that hyperinflation is coming in 2010?
Well, it's not going to hit in 2010. I mean, it's going to hit eventually if we don't change policies. There's still time to do the right thing. There's still time to significantly raise interest rates, to let a lot of these phony financial companies fail, to let the housing market finish its correction. It's not too late, but it's going to involve some tough choices politically.
Peter, you understand, though, hyperinflation would imply an inflation rate of over 50% by definition.
Well, it could be a lot higher than that. But I said it's not coming in 2010, but it might come in 2012, 2013, 2014 if we don't take the correct measures today. But so far, we are marching down the road to hyperinflation because we are pursuing the very policies that every other nation pursued that eventually had hyperinflation. So we have to make the tough political choices to shrink government and to stop the spending and to stop the money printing before it's too late to make those decisions.
Well, Peter, an inflation rate of over 50% in this environment is rather absurd right now, but we'll see what happens.
No, it's not. Remember, the countries that have the highest rates of inflation have high rates of unemployment. You don't have hyperinflation in times of full employment. Look, you have it in times of high unemployment.
Peter, it's Karen. So you have no faith Bernanke's going to do the right thing?
Well, he hasn't done the right thing yet. I don't know why he's going to change, change tunes.
All right, Peter, we're going to leave it there. Peter Schiff, thanks so much for joining us. Have a great holiday.
Thank you.
I dig Pete.
You dig Pete.
He says what's on his mind. He's unabashed. I mean, he's got a view and he sticks to it. Good for him.
Yeah.
I mean, he can be somewhat polarizing at times, but I think he's soft enough.
Like here on this desk.
Nah, he's much better than he used to be.
Soft side of Peter's.
That's quite a statement.
All right. Let's move on to the next right here. If you raise it, they will come. That seems to be the latest.